And last discussion, we had discussed description of a wave, and we had started discussing wave terminologies. So we had discussed in detail the crest and trough of a transverse wave, and amplitude of a transverse wave, and wavelength of a transverse wave. So we ended the discussion there. We'll start from wavelength. So we can define wavelength here, like we can define wavelength, distance between two consecutive in phase points on a wave. So we discussed in very detail what are two in phase points. So we can have an easy version of this definition, that is distance between two consecutive crests or troughs on a wave. So if we have a numerical, and if we have a situation, a wave is passing a point. So if there are some waves approaching a point, so for example, if we have here that these waves are approaching point A, so these waves are approaching point A, and this distance is given to you. For example, this distance is 10 meters. So what will be the wavelength here? So we have in a specific region, we have a number of waves. So I hope you can identify these number of waves. This is one wave, and then we have a second wave. So there are two waves in a region of 10 meters. So length of one wave will be 5 meters. So we can formulate for wavelength is distance or given length upon number of waves. Distance covered or given length upon number of waves is the wavelength. Now you can also find out the unit of wavelength here. Now distance is in meters, number of waves doesn't have a unit. So unit of wavelength will be meters because it's a distance. Or you can have a multiple or submultiple of that, means it can be centimeters, millimeters, or it can be in kilometers or some other distance. Okay, so that will be for wavelength. So then we can have, and if it is given to you, for example, other than that, if you have a waveform given to you of displacement of particles against distance covered by the wave, and you have this waveform drawn on that, and for example, a scale is given to you also, like this is 5, this is 10, starting from 0, and 15, and 20, so on. And distance is in, for example, centimeters. So you can find out the wavelength from this waveform also. So length of one wave according to scale is 10 centimeters. Length of half wave is 5 centimeters. Length of two waves is 20 centimeters. So length of one wave is 10 centimeters. So wavelength is 10 centimeters. So we can have also a measurement of wavelength from displacement against distance graph or waveform. Okay, I hope that's clear to you. You can answer different questions. I'll be sharing a worksheet also at the end. Okay, now we can have a discussion of time period. Time period, as the terminology explains, time taken by one wave. Time taken by one wave. So how can we take it out? For example, we have the same situation here. We have a wave approaching. We have a wave approaching some point A. It's approaching that point A. And there is a specific time taken for that. For example, 6 seconds are taken for that activity. 6 seconds is the time taken for these waves to approach or cross a point A. So there are two waves here. So if time taken for two waves is 6 seconds, so time taken by one wave will be 3 seconds. Okay, so time period of this wave will be 3 seconds. So we can define time period here, that is time taken by one complete wave to pass a point or to approach a point. So this is a time, so its unit will be seconds, and the symbol will be capital T. Now that's an important thing. There is a difference between capital T and small t. Small t is any time taken, any time interval, any distance, any difference between two intervals, but capital T stands specifically for time period. So time period is the time taken by one happening, time taken by one oscillation, time taken by one wave, that is time period. Both have the same unit. Unit is seconds for both of these symbols. Okay. We can also deduce the time period from a graph. So earlier we discussed displacement against distance graph, but we can also draw a graph that is displacement of particles against time taken. So when time is passing by, distance is being covered by the wave and particles are vibrating. So this will also have the same graph. Graph shape will be like this. So if you have this graph drawn and it has some values, for example, 0, 2, 4, 6. So you can also take time period from here. So time taken by one complete wave is 4 seconds. So 4 seconds will be your capital T. 4 seconds will be your time period. There can be a formula for time period also. Time taken upon number of waves passed or number of waves approached. You can look at the formula here. Time taken upon number of waves is equals to capital T. That is time period. So you can deduce the unit from this formula. That is, time taken will be in seconds. Number of waves doesn't have a unit. So unit for time period will be seconds. Okay, I hope that's clear to all of you. Erase it and we'll move on to the next terminology, that is frequency. So frequency is number of happenings in a unit time, number of waves in a unit time, number of oscillations in a unit time. So that is known as frequency. So here in this scenario, you can say number of waves in a second is the frequency of a wave. And its formula will be, the symbol for frequency is small f, and that is number of waves upon time taken. So number of wave doesn't have a unit. Time taken unit is in seconds. So unit for frequency will be 1 upon seconds, or s minus 1, or hertz. Okay, so 1 upon second or s minus 1. I wanted to raise it as a power, so that is s power minus 1. And you can have a unit hertz also, that's a named unit. So now I want you to have a close look at the formula of time period and frequency. Formula for frequency is number of waves upon time taken, and formula for time period is time taken upon number of waves. So you will observe that both are inverse of each other. So we can have a relation here of frequency and time period. Frequency is 1 upon t, or time period is 1 upon f. Both are inverse of each other. Units of both are also inverse of each other. Okay. Now moving on to wave speed. Wave speed is the speed of the wave. So I hope you remember what used to be the formula of speed: distance covered upon time taken. So if I take it to a wave, distance covered by one wave and time taken by one wave. So let me write it like wave speed, symbol of speed is v. So wave speed is distance covered upon time taken, and distance covered by one wave is wavelength, and time taken by one wave is time period. So it means we can say that wave speed is, let me change the color, we can say wave speed is lambda upon t. Wave speed is lambda upon t, and we have also We can also replace 1 upon t with something, that is 1 upon t can be replaced with f. So v will also be equals to f lambda. So wave speed can be given two ways, lambda upon capital T or f lambda. Now you already know the unit of wave speed or any speed is meters per second. So here also, if you put the units of both the things, you will get the same unit, that is meters per second. I hope that's clear to all of you, all these terminologies. We will discuss one more terminology, that is compression and rarefaction and wavelength for longitudinal wave, but we'll do that in very detail in the next chapter, sound. So here we have some detailed discussion of a transverse wave. Okay. So let me share a worksheet with you too. Yes, this worksheet. So I will scroll it so that you can solve the question. You can pause it and solve the questions on a paper. What is carried by wave? Name the type of wave which moves at right angles to the disturbance. Give an example of this type of wave. Name the type of wave which moves parallel to direction of its disturbance. Disturbance means the source. Okay, now we have two waveforms. Shows the displacement of wave changes with distance. B shows displacement against time. Mark the in the diagram following terms: amplitude, wavelength, and time period. So amplitude will be maximum displacement. Wavelength will be distance between two consecutive crests, and time period will be drawn on this waveform. So wavelength can be drawn on this waveform, displacement against distance, and time period can be drawn on this waveform, displacement against time. Define the following terms: amplitude, wavelength, you can do that, frequency, period. And then we have another question. In the water wave shown, the wavelength is represented by horizontal distance between the points. Wavelength is the horizontal distance between the points. So we can state, we can select two points here. So I hope you understand that we cannot select point P and Q. Point P and Q are not in phase, P and R are in phase. So distance between P and R will be one wavelength. And do we have some other option? No, we do not have any other option. So distance between point P and R will be exactly one wavelength. These two points are same displacement and direction of vibration is same. So P and R, these two points are in phase. Question number 7, what is the unit used to measure frequency? You know that it frequency and time period relation, and we have a question here. I guess that will be solved with the relation V equals to F lambda. And then you have another question. So you can solve this question as a practice. So that will be all for this. Next time we'll be discussing reflection on diffraction of the waves, wavefront. We'll be doing that. I hope you got all of it. If you have a question, you can share that in comments below. And you need to like and subscribe this video. And you need to press the bell icon so that you get all the videos in future. Now,